What's new in accessibility at Google?
Hi, everyone. It's Laura Allen again, Head of Strategy and Programs for Accessibility and Disability Inclusion here at Google. Welcome back to another episode of What's New in Google Accessibility, a series where we share new ways that we're making our products and features more accessible for everyone. In this episode, we'll talk about accessibility updates coming to products like ChromeOS, Android, Workspace, and more. So let's jump into it, starting with text-to-speech in ChromeOS. Earlier this year, we added new, more natural-sounding text-to-speech voices to ChromeOS, so people now have a variety of different voices and languages to choose from.
Googlers with disabilities make critical contributions across the company.
Text-to-speech allows users to hear text on their screen read aloud. This functionality can be helpful for individuals who have visual impairments, like me, or those who prefer to listen to content rather than read it. The new voice options can be used with ChromeVox, Chromebook's built-in screen reader, as well as Select-to-Speak, which allows for desired portions of pages to be read aloud. In Android news, we have a few exciting updates. First, we created a video tutorial series that offers tips for how to leverage some of our accessibility features and personalize your Android device based on your disability. For example, here's a clip from our video, How to Navigate Your Phone Using Facial Gestures. We take a look at camera switches and Project Activate, two features that can help people use their phones through eye movements and facial gestures. Also in Android news, we've made some major updates to Lookout, our app that uses your phone's camera to read text, find objects, and more. This spring, we launched selfie and capture buttons for images mode, which lets users take a photo with Lookout and hear AI-generated descriptions of whatever they've photographed. Like in this example, we've taken a landscape photo, and Lookout will describe the hills, river, and hot air balloon in the sky.
In this picture, we can see the hills and there is a river. We can see a balloon in the air, and in the background, we can see the sky with clouds.
In May, we added Find Mode to Lookout's set of features, which lets users locate specific objects by selecting them from a drop-down list. We also made improvements to the quality of Lookout's optical character recognition, which means that the app can more easily identify text and handwritten words while it's in text or images mode.
Dear Gabriel, thanks so much for your thoughtful gift. It was great seeing you last week. Hope we can do it again soon. XOXO, Aiden.
And we introduced happiness tracking surveys to Lookout so users can easily share their feedback directly in the app. We definitely encourage you to share your thoughts. Workspace is also an area where we've been rolling out lots of accessibility features, like in Google Meet. Up until recently, one of the common ways people asked a question in Meet was by clicking on the hand raise icon or typing a keyboard shortcut. Now, there's a feature in settings that lets you raise your physical hand when you want to speak. Google Meet will recognize it with gesture detection and notify all meeting participants. We also updated our layout options in Google Meet so users can customize what they see on their screens. This option can be great for people who want to reduce screen clutter and see only participants with their video feeds shown. For Google Drive, we're excited to announce that Drive's web application now supports first letters navigation, a method for quickly finding files and folders. First letters navigation is useful for anyone who depends on or prefers to use a keyboard, including screen reader users. If a user wants to locate a document they've titled Leadership and Organization, for example, instead of navigating with arrow keys, they would type the first letter of the file, in this case L, and Drive would jump to the first item that begins with that letter. Also, in Drive on web, users can now update their setting to dark mode, which creates a darker background with light text. For some people, this can make visuals clearer while reducing eye strain. In Google Calendar, we're replacing the appointment slots feature with a more accessible and improved appointment schedule option. With appointment schedules, you can create and share booking pages so people can book time with you, and you can view booked appointments alongside your schedule in Google Calendar. And lastly, since we retired our Gmail HTML view for desktop and mobile web, we've released a guide so that screen reader users can successfully make the switch from HTML to standard view. Definitely check it out if you haven't already. In Google Maps news, we're really excited to have released detailed voice guidance worldwide. Detailed voice guidance, originally rolled out in 2019, giving people the ability to receive more guidance and verbal announcements for walking trips. Here's a clip of Wakana using the feature as she navigates the streets of Tokyo. Detailed voice guidance confirms if someone is on the correct route, the distance until their next turn, or if they're approaching a busy intersection. This feature has been a game changer for me personally, especially when on unfamiliar routes. And it's helpful for anyone who can't easily look at their phone while walking. We consider it a virtual curb cut that benefits many people. Previously, the feature was only available in English in the United States and Japanese in Japan. Now, users anywhere in the world can use detailed voice guidance in all languages that Maps supports. Thanks for tuning in to another episode of What's New in Google Accessibility. We hope you've enjoyed learning about some of our recent efforts to improve our accessibility products and features. Be sure to check out our YouTube video notes, where we've linked to more details about many of these updates. If you want to learn more, sign up for our accessibility newsletter at g.co/a11y/news or by clicking the link in the description of this video. Bye for now.